guys, it's Celia, and today I'll be doing a review of Zotto's Professional All About Curls products. I picked up this trial kit because I've heard this brand is like a dupe for Diva Curl. Now, although I've never had an issue with my Diva Curl products, after all those women came out with hair loss, I just did not feel right using their products. So, from this kit, they had their No Lather Cleanser and their Daily Cream Conditioner, which the No Lather Cleanser I did not use. It's pretty much a co-wash and I do not co-wash. But the Daily Cream Conditioner I did use after I shampooed, and y'all, I didn't hate it, but it needed so much more slip, more moisture, and I just probably would never use it again. Yeah, I didn't want to film the wash day process. Just, I don't know why. I just didn't feel like it, y'all, honestly. But I'm just taking my Goddess Curls Divine Hair Elixir, putting that into my scalp, massaging it so I can get that hair growth, moisturize my scalp. And I will have a 6-month update video coming either this week or next week. So stay tuned for that. But then I am just going to section off my hair, spray it on down with water, with my Goddess Curls spray bottle, and then we'll get into the styling products. So this is their Bouncy Cream. It's supposed to give touchable soft definition, and I didn't mention, but all of the products are free of sulfates, silicones, and parabens, and I really loved that this was a thicker product compared to their conditioner, which was a bit lighter. I love thick creamy products, like you guys know, but the moisture, this had so much more moisture compared to the conditioner. And I know they're two different products, but that conditioner just wasn't doing it for me. So yeah, the Bouncy Cream was easy to work on through my hair. I can't say it gave me tons of definition, especially compared to other products I have used, but I'm using it solely just for moisture underneath the gel, so that really wasn't an issue for me. I will say I wasn't a fan of the smells of the conditioner and the cleanser. They have this like real earthy smell, but the gel and the Bouncy Cream had a lighter smell. That it was cool, but yeah, they could have better scents. So I am just detangling my section of hair, and then I am going to go in with the high definition gel. Now, this high definition gel is supposed to give crunchless ultra hold, and the directions just say to apply to wet hair, scrunch upward, and air dry or diffuse. So the consistency of this, I feel like initially it might appear like it's like lightweight, but this is actually a nice like thick type of gel, at least for me it was. I really enjoyed that because I need, you know, thicker, for the most part, thicker, heavier gels. But don't get me wrong, there are lightweight gels that do still give you that definition and hold. But yeah, this definitely felt nice and moisturizing. I totally forgot to mention ingredients, you guys, but just looking at the four ingredient or the four products that I have, all of them have either sweet almond oil, coconut oil, shea butter. This gel has castor oil in it, so they do have, you know, those type of ingredients. But I just went ahead and raked this on in, and I did definitely like the definition I got. I feel like my hair wasn't super duper as wet as it could have been, so the curls aren't popping right here. They're popping, but they're not popping. So I'll show you another clip. But once I did go in and coil or shingle my hair, whatever you want to call it, that's when the curls really popped like a ton, you guys. So that is what I'm gonna do. You guys know this is the way I choose to do my wash and goes, just because of the curl definition, the shape, all that. If I didn't mention, all of these products range, well, the normal size, the regular size, goes for $10.99 each, and you get anywhere from I think an 11 to 15 ounce product, which I think is a great amount of product for the price. So far I was loving these products, y'all, except for the conditioner. But I'm just gonna fast forward and let you guys see the rest of the process. Thank you. guys, I was totally off of my game. I forgot to do my spin around before I got underneath the hooded dryer. So my apologies for that. I let my hair dry and then this is my hair completely dry. But y'all, I fell asleep. I don't know what I was on this day. I fell asleep on my hair. So, it's a little bit, I feel like it still looks good. It's a little bit smushed. I didn't even bother trying to fluff it and all that because I just wanted to get this video done before I mess something else up. So I'm gonna do a spin around for you guys now. You guys can definitely see the coils are coiling. They're super defined. They look really, really good. I will say that you guys will see in a second, there was a little bit of white residue at the top, which I'm so glad it wasn't all over because I don't know if I used too much of the cream or too much of the gel, but you guys could see the white residue when I was shingling it, so I'm glad that majority of it dried. But yeah, the white residue went away with some water or oil, I can't remember. But yeah, I did have a little bit of crunch, but it was super easy to just scrunch it on out. So yeah, that's basically this review. I definitely loved the bouncy cream. Definitely loved the high definition gel. Next time I just won't fall asleep on my hair. But as far as this being a dupe for Diva Curl, I truly don't know, you guys. I don't know. I wasn't a fan of the conditioner, and I know that Diva Curl has great hair masks, which I love. But I don't know. I'm just not even gonna compare it, you know. I'm just gonna let it be its own brand. So I'm gonna show you guys third day hair. This is going to be the next clip, and I had something else to film, which is why I was rewashing it, but I could have easily just did my edges, fluffed this out a bit, maybe added a headband, whatever, and this would have been a look. I still feel like it looked really, really good for third day hair. The coils are still there. The moisture was definitely still there. So that's my review, guys. Let me know if you guys have tried this brand, if you've used them, what your thoughts on them are. Do you think it's a dupe for Diva Curl? I would love to know. But that's the end of this video. Like, comment, share, subscribe, you guys, and I'll see you in another one.